Ami, I'm Pep. First of all, congratulations for the league. You all deserve. And I hear that you have a concussion and you are in hospital. Hopefully you can recover as soon as possible, as quick as possible. And you can come back home, your family, friends, and the team and celebrate this victory. Stay safe, stay well, and I wish you all the best.
Between that second division I-League and the ISL final in terms of Amir Anawde, who played throughout that tournament and then unfortunately had that injury. By the way, do we have an update on how he's doing?
Yeah, so Mumbai City has put out an update. They've taken a photograph of Amir. He's stable. He is in the hospital, but he's still under observation because as concussion injuries go, you have to be under observation for the next 48 hours. Right, yeah. So you might be stable now, but something could occur. So yeah, much love to Amay, much love to the medical staff, right? The importance of the medical staff. I don't know if you remember, Jaideep sir, Chennai mein ek local league mukabla ho raha tha bahut time pehle, jahan pe a boy unfortunately succumbed to an injury because there was no proper medical staff present at the thing. And it was post that, right? It was post that that it was decided that you have to have an ambulance ready at the game, at any time, irrespective of what level of the game you're playing, you have to have medical support at the time. And you saw the same last night. It was scary. And it was good news in the sense it was good work by the broadcasters. They were purposely not showing the pictures. They were purposely not showing the pictures.
No, so that is against FIFA COVID FIFA protocol. You cannot, concussion thing, you cannot show. That's FIFA protocol only. And I think the two biggest incidents, Arjun, if you remember, very unfortunate incidents happened. One is in 89 or 90, when Sanjeev Datta playing for Bengal in the Santosh Trophy in Kerala, he died on the spot. He was taken to the hospital and he did not recover. And second incident happened in 2005.
Cristiano.
2004, Cristiano in junior boy. In that was November 5, because I was personally present there, so I remember
it. Dempo versus Mohan Bagan
at the Kanti Rava Stadium. It was 78th minute, he fell down on the ground and he never recovered. So keeping in mind those two incidents, even we all of us were like you and anybody else, we were very worried about it.
True, absolutely. Whether you're in Mumbai, whether you're in Delhi, whether you're watching on television,
it really doesn't matter where you are. And yeah. Amay is another is unfortunate for him. Amay, we had a special year for him. We were looking at him specially because he is a player who has come from second division straight away to the ISL.
Yeah.
See, he was playing for Bangalore United, and then from second division he has been taken away straight into Mumbai, and Lobera has given him a break in the first 11. So he's a big success story of Indian football. So we hope that he recovers very soon and returns to the pitch as fast as possible.
I'm just saying, you know, at a time like this, when everyone is talking about Amay, I feel like you have to give credit to the medical staff because there is so much pressure at the time when that boy is there. You saw moments when the boy wanted to enter the field again, right? And then,
that happens in concussion.
that happens
in concussion. People lose things and they try to stand up. So generally what happens, the medical staff don't allow them to stand up. But when they insist, they allow him to stand up. Once he tries to stand up, he collapses again. Then the medical staff take care of him. It happens like that only. I think he wanted to stand up himself.
He did. We could see that. They picked out one picture at that time, thinking at least that he's recovered. So the picture came, but you saw that he hadn't recovered. And it was good work by the medical staff who said, no, you are not getting back on the field. You need to get back in the ambulance because you need to be straight away put under observation. Because then, sir, at that time, nothing is more important. An ISL final, an ISL team, nothing is more important.
Even if it is World Cup final, how does it matter?
Nothing is more important. So I must just say that you must give due credit to the medical staff. Look, see, Anibhai, my point is this. Throughout this tournament, a medical staff at Max would have been treating a pull, an ankle injury, a scratch or a head injury, nothing serious as opposed to what you saw last night. The culmination of the tournament, 4.5 months. So it's like we keep saying about defenders, right? आप डिफेंडर व्हेन इज ही कॉट आउट बाय सरप्राइज, 90 मिनट के गेम में कोई अटैक नहीं कर रहा, सडनली 88 मिनट में स्ट्राइकर ने रन मार दिया, वो भी घुल गया, ये क्या हो गया, वो गोल मार के चले गया. इट वॉज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ मोमेंट फॉर द मेडिकल स्टाफ एट द एंड ऑफ द सीजन एंड सडनली दिस हैपेंड. आई थॉट दे डिड अ वेरी गुड जॉब, दे टुक देयर टाइम, took their time, and that's it. Move ahead.
So the role of the officials in this case and the match commissioner and all of that is also very important, because as is the case in any team, and we've seen like concussion or CTE, what they call traumatic encephalopathy, which leads to concussion. So a lot of this happens in the NFL, the National Football League in America, American football. And after years and years of research जो यहाँ पे हम public interest litigation कहते हैं, वहाँ पे वो class action lawsuit कहते हैं. So after several years of fighting, all these athletes who have gone through this head trauma, injury trauma, finally they were paid out more than $700 million to these 18,000 athletes who've been impacted by head injuries in football, in American football. And as a result of some of these studies and some of the efforts being made in the United Kingdom and Europe and all of that, you will find that in countries like the UK, in the US, for under 14 players, heading is completely banned in terms of training. And then even for the later stage, 14 to 16, I guess, it's limited to 30 hours. Because studies have shown that repeated heading of the ball leads to impact on the brain. And whether you're young or old or whatever, these things, the trouble with these kind of injuries is that you might get up and you might be fine immediately, but the long-term damage or the impact on the nervous system, on the brain, is massive, and it's a subject that football needs to, I think, engage with far more deeply. Like you're saying, credit to everyone, and it's great to see that at least at the Premier League or the top division levels, and perhaps even a couple of levels down, there are protocols in place that make sure that, because see, if it's a key player, just using yesterday's case as an example. Maybe a young player like Amir Anawde can be replaced, right? But if you have, let's say, someone like a Roy Krishna in that situation who picks up a head injury, the coaching staff, the medical staff, automatically their mindset is, let's try and get the guy back on the pitch. Because end of the day, two things. One is that football has become all about winning. And the second is that it's a hyper-macho, hyper-masculine environment in which players are given more credit. When you look at iconic images, you remember things like players bleeding and bandaged while being on the pitch. The terminology that we use is very similar to the terminology that we use.
But last night, last night was not that, bhai. Whether it was Amay or anyone, you could kind of make out that irrespective of who the player might have been, it was a decision that was taken. We don't care whether it's the final of the World Cup or the ISL, boss. Get into that ambulance. You're going under observation. So that is why I'm giving them credit. That they didn't even try. They didn't even think of it. 100%. Boom, in.
100%, yeah. And it's great to see that like players and coaching staff and medical staff, everyone is kind of now much more aware of these things and much more aware of the long-term impact it can have. And you're absolutely right what both of you guys were saying. It doesn't matter whether it's an ISL final or a World Cup final. I mean, there are some things that are,
far more
important than a game of football. So, hopefully he does recover and there's nothing major in terms of impact. But, these things do kind of add up also. The other thing that medically they say is that maybe up to 5 concussions is fine, but 6 and beyond, you're under serious then threat of long-term problems, like early onset dementia, all of this stuff. In fact, so I was reading another book by a guy who I talk about quite often, Michael Calvin. He's a UK-based journalist who has written extensively on modern football. I think this one is called, I've forgotten the name, but you guys chat, I'll bring it up sometime later. But it's called Under the Skin of the Modern Game or something like that. It's called really interesting book that starts off with a lot of the work that is going on by families of players and others who have been affected by these kind of things. You know, talking about the kind of widespread impact and also the lack of care in terms of, because these things happen through playing the sport regularly at a high level for several years, right? So whether it's the PFA, which is the Players Association in the UK, or other governing bodies, FIFPro, et cetera, how much care through these bodies is given to players once they retire so that they can manage the medical issues that come up over the course of their career. Interesting for any of you guys to pick up.
Please keep telling us on the community. These boys love sport, they love football, and you know, I'd love to read all these books. Yeah. I'm just saying, so on the chat, the boys are saying that Ame is back at the team hotel. He's clicking pics with the trophy. So that is good news. And, you know, much love to the family. I'm just, because at that time, Jaideep sir, I was sitting with a friend in Bombay watching this. Both of us are guys who love sport, who've been around sport. We've played from school level, whatever. And both of us, our expressions changed. You know, we were just saying, ki ye kya ho raha hai? Shit. We were like this. Exactly what the boys were doing on the field, the teammates and the opponents. So mere dimag mein ye hai, just imagine Ame's family is watching right now on television. You're not in Goa. You're dependent on what the television is showing you or whatever messaging you're getting. You're helplessly calling up the team now. And it's a tough, harrowing situation to be. And it's a situation you would want no one to be in.
Yeah, certainly. At least there are a lot of things. Now the facilities are more, people are more aware. There are other ambulances available, so many things. I remember when 1989, when Sanjeev Datta died, Raja, he was called, I think, no, those days. He died in one of the Kerala cities. I forget the name. There was nobody. There was not even an ambulance. He was taken in a, I think somehow an ambulance was brought. He was taken to a hospital and it was too late. And his family never only came to know next morning that it has happened. Because those days communication was not so strong. You can understand only there was not much television and all this internet or anything. So how did they feel sitting in Howrah district? He is from district Howrah, sitting in district Howrah. How did his parents feel? It's a very, when you think about it, you feel that how can you handle such situation? How can you face such a situation? Yeah. But it do happens. Football is after all, football is a body contact game.
Yep.
That's the biggest problem or that the biggest plus point of football. You can't really see when Subhashish went up and he also went up. Nobody thought that this is going to happen, isn't it?
Yeah.
Subhashish, of course, went for a tough header. That's all. He didn't want to hurt anyone, but it happened. But it's good to know that from, as you were saying, that he's back and clicking photos with the trophy and all.
Yeah, that's always good to hear. I'm just saying, sorry. So I know we're here to talk about the game, but this is part of the game. It transpired in the game. And it's important that Jaideep sir is referring to what has happened in the past. Because in some ways, you've kind of said, okay, we've changed things. And this yesterday, what has happened, has told you that you're moving on the right track. Not just on the field, but you're moving in the right track in terms of the safety of the players, in terms of how you're looking after them medically. And so that way, it was a big success for Indian football, I would have to say. I'm just saying, Ani bhai, just imagine that incident has happened, your teammate that has happened to you, and you've gone into halftime. As Lobera, now that is where your man management skills, your messaging, how you speak to the players, and usko bhai kitna time mila hoga, usko mushkil se 30 second mile honge to regroup and talk to the players and to get them like this, to snap them out of it, right? What a tough situation for even like a Lobera, who's probably been Spain, who's been a part of Barcelona. It would have been a situation he's never been a part of. And that's where you grow as a person, as a coach, of how you handle that situation.
Yeah, totally, man. And like he said in the post-match interview as well, you know, the most important trophy is every trophy. And these factors, I think, all of the circumstances that lead up to that situation where at the 90th minute, one of your young players, a guy you put tremendous amounts of confidence and faith in throughout the season.
45th minute.
No, I was talking about in the end.
That's a Bipin, yeah.
Okay. Winning goal, yeah. You know, kind of like those moments then like vindicate or justify or whatever all of the struggles, everything that you've gone through over the course of maybe not just one season, but perhaps several seasons. And as a, like for a head coach, I think to have to deal with something that obviously will, like you were saying, as guys who have played before and who have seen this happen as well, your thoughts immediately were, oh man, what's going on? So obviously yeah. The players on the pitch are also thinking the same thing. So to get them to sort of refocus on something that in comparison seems as so trivial, right? Like it's a game of football, that to a half of football. How do you sort of weigh that against potentially someone's life, someone's career, someone's all of those things? And yet you have to remember that is what you are there for, what you're getting paid for. It's your job, et cetera, et cetera. So, you know, and you owe something to the fans, you owe something to whoever is backing you in terms of your club ownership. So you have to get out there and get the job done. And it can always go either way, right? I think when Ame came off, young Mohammad Raqib, who was again part of that under-17 World Cup setup, he was brought on. And it almost became a game changer in terms of that offside goal that wasn't given in the end. So you know, the way things played out yesterday, Lubera might look back and say, okay, great learning experience, and things worked out all right for us on this occasion. But I think he'll also have the realization or the acceptance that very easily things could have gone completely differently.
True.
And that's why I think so many of us are so obsessed with this sport, because in so many ways it's kind of like it reflects what's happening in the world beyond the pitch as well. That you think you are in control, you think you are, you know, driving the course of history or how things are going to play out. But you actually realize through these events, these circumstances, that you have very little that you can really control in terms of the outcome of things.
Fair enough. I'm just for all the viewers, because they're saying, why are you guys so serious today? Look, firstly, this is a very serious topic and I feel it needs to be discussed. And if you've got three people who have watched the game from beyond your Bajegi CT Udega ball, from way before that, then it's only right that we tell you what the scene used to be. Sir, I'll tell you one more thing. Yesterday, what happened in your mind? You were there in the game when Dempo's incident happened. Armando was the coach, right?
Yeah.
I remember a few years after, or the next year, when Armando was playing an I-League game for them, this team was playing in Kolkata, a Federation Cup game, I think it was. It was versus Churchill. Ogba Kalu tha. Wahan pe Ranti aur Kalu ke beech mein clash hua. They were taken to the hospital. My job was to interview Armando post the game. And I could see Armando was shaking. I could see it. Which is why before asking him anything about the sport or the game, I said, sir, please give us an update on Ranti and Kalu. And he sort of mellowed down. He said, thanks, Arjun, because I wouldn't have been able to talk about the game. This is the only thing that's in my mind, having gone through what's happened with Cristiano. And so it stays with you for so long. And I'm guessing it will still stay with him always throughout his life, that he was part of that dressing room, that team talk when that happened.
Yeah, because he has burned his finger once.
Yeah.
And the man who scored both the goals in the final did not return to the dressing room.
Yeah.
Dude, that was harrowing experience for all of us, I would say. So it didn't happen like anything like that. Here the boy is back and clicking photos with a trophy.
Yeah,
it really, really, really makes you happy to learn.
It does.
About.
It does. It does.
Think about Junior. He scored both the goals. Dempo won 2-0. He scored both the goals. Dempo took the trophy home. But the man who scored both the goals did not return to the dressing room.
Mm.
You went there with 11 and you returned with 10. How does it feel?
True.
I can't imagine the situation again. It happened so many years ago, but it still haunts me.
Yeah.
I saw him falling down on the pitch. And it was 78th minute. I still remember because he scored the goal. He headed in. He fell down on the pitch. And we thought, he will get up. So every journalist in the stadium noted down the timing and then I looked up and he was still lying. Then the ambulance came and picked him up and went back to the went to the hospital and the match resumed. But he never returned.
He never returned.
Remember, I went to the hospital. I think Mr. Colasso, he was the general secretary of the AFF at that time. He called me from the hospital. He says, please come. He is no more. So I went there. And I remember how Ranty Martins was howling. He was crying loudly. What a scene it was. My God.
Mm.
You will find coaches and management of some of the clubs, especially in the junior level, they always complain that the federation wants an ambulance to be present at the ground whenever a match is played. And how can we afford? We don't have so much money. We are hand to mouth condition. They don't know how we are running the club, how we are paying the boys, but. I always support the federation in this. If you can't put an ambulance, you can't put the medical stuff, then don't play. Please don't play.
True.
Nobody has asked you to play. You shouldn't play. You close to shut down your club and go home.
Yeah, absolutely. 2500-3000 rupees jo lagte hain ambulance khada karne ke liye ek डेढ़ घंटे के लिए जो training session या match hota hai. I mean, if you and it's like insurance, right? As long as things are fine, it's all fine. You feel like, oh, why am I, wasting this money on insurance? But it's only when things like this happen that you realize how vital it is. And I mean, of course, in this case, I'm sure the costs of the medical facilities are borne by the organizers.
Yeah.
But that's not the. I mean, in the I-League, for example, even now when they are in their bubble in Calcutta. Even for training sessions, it's a requirement that an ambulance be present so that if anything happens to a player, there's immediate and like because that immediate time when an injury takes place, that's the
crucial.
When if medical attention is given, then and given how the advances in medical sciences, you can save lives literally. So putting a value to that is absolutely impossible, and 100% in agreement with Jaideep when he says that like clubs that. Complain about not being able to do this. I mean, you can always find a way to do it, and there's literally no way to say that is something that should be done away with.
Absolutely, I'm going to move on now to the game. But to all the people watching, look, this was possibly the most important topic that's come out of the game. I'm sorry, you might be a Mumbai supporter, you might be a ATK supporter, but yesterday was a success story for Indian football. That you have looked after a kid who's fallen down, who's had such a serious injury, and now the kid is fine, hale and hearty, he's back with his team. That is a success story of Indian football. So one must celebrate that, one must talk about it, and one must not forget what has happened in the past. You must not forget what's happened in the past, because what's happened in the past then sort of tells you to make sure the future is better. And you don't repeat those mistakes of the past. So, okay. So, much love to Amer Anawde. Much love to the medical staff that helped him. And we hope he has a very hale and hearty career going forward.